Hi, I'm Gina Cerimele, a PhD student at Colorado State University in the Crop Adaptation Lab. In our lab, our main goal is to find and make accessible adaptive alleles or genes to adapt crops to the ever-changing stressors we're encountering in current life. We do this by accessing a really wide pool of genetic diversity that's shaped by millions and millions of years of evolutionary time, and it all really begins with crop domestication, the foundation of modern agriculture. There's three traits that are really widely associated with plant domestication. The first is that you're actually able to harvest the seed from the plants. Wild plants tend to shatter their seeds all over the ground so they can continue growing, you know, season after season. And so non-shattering is a sign of domestication, as well as increased fruit size or grain size, and also a more increased palatability or reduction of these astringent kind of bitter compounds that are present in a lot of wild plants, their fruits and grains. And domestication across hundreds of crops in different geographic locations has given rise to this huge pool of genetics and genes that we can look into to breed more climate smart, more nutritionally beneficial, more culturally sensitive crops. So plant breeding leverages this diversity to address problems in agriculture in a variety of ways. We can look into these genomes, pull out the traits that might be useful for us to adapt to drought or an insect outbreak, and able to put them into a modern variety that farmers are growing all around the country. Another way is what we refer to as de novo domestication, which is where new crops are created entirely. So think of those three traits I mentioned earlier and how those are selected for in an otherwise wild species, and then it's developed into a crop that farmers will actually grow in their fields one day. And so by leveraging all of these different tactics, as well as the genetic diversity we see from domestication and from evolutionary time differentiating plant species, we're able to really address and tackle some of agriculture's biggest issues, things like climate change, things like cultural needs for crops, and things like fortification for nutrition.